Hello, I'm back to talk to you about Blade Runner 2049. Oh, I guess that's a bit blurry. Nah, you can make it out, whatever. Just looked a bit blurry for a moment on the screen, but yeah, so I saw this film, and it was pretty good. Quite honestly, I think it's actually better than the first movie. Film revolves around a replicant and a human replicated, or I've procreated and created a replicant human hybrid, and you know, don't want to give too much away, but you know, Ryan Gosling is a Blade Runner, and the superior officer is that of Robin Wright, who plays that. Okay, I'm gonna look up some more stuff here about the movie, about who's all in it. Jared Leto is the new guy. His name is Neander Wallace. He's essentially the new version of Tyrell, you know, the dude from the first film that made all the replicants. He's the new guy doing that, so. The movie is pretty good. Again, I mean, I know it's been out for some time, but not a lot of people went and saw it in the theater, and I guess you know, it's come out not too long ago. It's come out on January 65th, so it's been out for a few weeks now. I guess maybe not everybody the movie who has wanted to see it, because you know, perhaps money is tight. Is it on Netflix? It was on Netflix as of now, I guess, the following week after it came out on DVD and Blu-ray. And wanted to talk about this for a while, but you know, Harrison Ford has coming back into his old famous movie roles was Han Solo and Force Awakens, and now he's in this movie. And he's going to be Indiana Jones again. So, yeah. It's interesting to see actors reprise their roles later on in their career. He's had such a big career that you wouldn't have thought he'd ever be on Solo again. Wouldn't have thought he'd be Deckard again. And I guess in a way, might not have thought he'd be at Indiana Jones again. I guess it seemed like after the fourth Indiana Jones film, that would have been it. But nope. He's doing Indiana Jones 5. The acting was very good in this movie. Ryan Gosling is very good. You know, tries to find answers to this case of who this child is. And when he has suspicions, he's like, gotta have it confirmed. Need to make sure it's who he thinks it is. And then, yeah. It's a very beautifully shot movie. It's very visually amazing. People want this to win cinematography. This is going up against Dunkirk. And you all know how much I enjoy Dunkirk by now. I think it's the best film of the year. Last year, it was my favorite movie of last year. So I'm sort of biased in that regard. I'd like Dunkirk to win as many Oscars as it can win. Though if this film wins cinematography, I won't be upset at all. That's how it goes. You hope your preferred movie wins, but if it loses to something just as good in one aspect or another, I myself can't really find huge fault with that, honestly. It's a little disappointment in that your favorite or preferred, or at least preferred pick didn't win, but again, it's not the end of the world, it's just awards, and people for years have said some of these awards, like the Oscars, don't really mean a whole lot in regard of giving the absolute best to the best people of said year. And this film is very much up to that of some good technical awards, I would say. I find this a very entertaining movie. I think if you like the original Blade Runner, you'll enjoy this. And I know I'm not really talking about this movie a whole lot, at least in depth, but again, it just came out a few weeks ago. Maybe not everybody who wants to see it has seen it, because apparently it didn't do that great at the box office, and I didn't see it because other movies came out that I wanted to see during that time. So I finally saw it, but then, again, the fact that not many people saw it on the big screen, it could be a while, and I'm like, I just don't want to try and give a bunch of spoilers away, because for movies like that, it's usually like for Star Wars, Batman, stuff that people have seen. In this movie, people haven't seen, despite, you know, Blade Runner, which I do have right here. Blade Runner, it's a cult classic, and I always enjoyed this movie. Do I think it's a bit overhyped? Sure, I could see that. Though perhaps part of that is because when people really started to pay attention to this movie, gave it props it quite possibly did deserve at the time. Some may be trying to sort of overcompensate by saying it's phenomenal and this and that, and not to say this is can't be people's favorite movies, but the way people talk about it, it's like some people I've heard for reviews, or at least just talking about this, it seems like they're trying to, like, because of how it's now a cult movie and that it didn't do well at all at the box office because it came out around the same time E.T. did, and it failed, essentially, box office-wise. Or at least was a big disappointment. Sometimes people try and make it like a better movie than it actually is. But again, there are those who really love this movie, fine. But then there are those who... The ones I think I feel who try and make this a lot better than what it really is are those who have just discovered it and haven't really watched it or had seen it, but it's been so long and they've heard about the how many people enjoy this movie and they kind of want to try and fit in a way, and they do it by overcompensating, saying and just saying how phenomenal it is. And it is a good, entertaining movie, I will say that. And this is... My head. This is, too. But I think this film... is a better film than this. But then again, I have seen this a few times already. There's a thing for the back. seen this good many times. I've seen all the versions that are on here because there's 5 versions of this film. There's only 1 version of this film. That's another thing, that this film had various cuts. But, Jared Leto, yeah, he plays like the antagonistic dude who creates the replicants. And I will say he plays a weirdo, but then again, Jared Leto plays many weirdos. And so with this Blu-ray, we get special features. Never really done this, like list features. But I think it's kind of a good film, and a good pie. I thought. Familiarize yourself with the world of Blade Runner, Replicant Evolution, Blade Runners, Rise of Wallace Corp, Welcome to 2049, Joys, Within the Skies, Spinners, Pilot Fishing, Barracudas, Your Entry into the Visual Spectacle, Designing the World of Blade Runner 2049, and To Be Human, Casting Blade Runner 2049, and Prologues, 2022, Blackout, 2036, Nexus Dawn, and 2048, Nowhere to Run. And these prologues are short films to give the backstory between the original Blade Runner and this. So I think, if anything, that's another thing why this is a good buy, because you get this. One thing is, it is 164 minutes compared to the less than 2-hour run time. It's like the original movie was like an hour 57 minutes or so. Essentially just about 2 hours. This is over 2.5. So just be warned, if you go on this. Just be warned that this, you just pretty much clear out 3 hours of your day. Whether it be in the middle of the day or at night, whenever you're able to, you get this, or you watch it on Netflix, make sure 3 hours of your day is clear and free. Hopefully no interruptions will happen. Perhaps at least maybe a bathroom break or something. That could happen, where you pause the movie and then you continue on from where you left off after you went to the bathroom or did whatever, because it is a fairly long movie. That's one thing I will say. But, you know, it's a pretty good buy. I thought it was a good film. If you enjoy the original Blade Runner, like I did, I enjoyed it. Though, again, I will talk about the overhype of this film, of that film. I think some people may have seen it long ago or never saw it, but, you know, had heard. It's one of those things, when movies that has been around for now 35 years, as of this film, last year was the 35th anniversary of Blade Runner. When a film like that's been around for so many years, you know, people kind of hype it up. And when something is hyped up so much, when you finally see it, it can be very underwhelming. Or perhaps they really enjoyed it, but it kind of overcompensate to try and, you know, fit in if they thought it was okay, if they aren't of the side of, it was okay, but overrated. I can see how this could be overrated, because this is one of the biggest, highest rated films of the year that came out. Thought it was good. But just be warned that it could be potentially overrated, if you thought so, or if you, you saw the original Blade Runner, and you liked it, you thought it was good, but weren't entirely as impressed as others, possibly could feel the same way here, but if not, you know, hey, good for, I hope you'll have a good time watching 2049. I enjoyed it. I thought it was good, and yeah, it's really all I gotta say. Good film. And Harrison Ford said he would, if a third film was to be made, he'd be interested in coming aboard. So if Blade Runner 3 happens, we could see Harrison Ford once again. Seems like it has a potential sequel, but then again, with the box office of this not being so great as people hoped, we'll see. We'll have to see also how the Blu-ray and DVD sales go. Sometimes that can actually help make the decision. Like, okay, it did later make money on home video, so there is an audience. But if you have, you are a fan of Blade Runner, I would suggest watching this film, because it is quite a spectacle to see. It's a very visual spectacle, at the very least. It's visually great. If you're not that invested with the story, which I found interesting, but again, didn't get into it a whole lot, because not as many people have seen it as at least the original Blade Runner. And though perhaps as of now, it's been a few weeks, people might have. So if that's the case, go out and buy it or watch it on Netflix, and then if you liked it, buy it or whatever. Yeah, that's all I really have to say. And, yeah. Until next time. See you later. Peace out.